Hello everybody. After a long break, we continue with our interviews and today we have a very special guest. So the CEO of Montblanc, Mr. Nicola Baretsky, will be our guest today. So Nicola, welcome.
Thank you very
welcome
much,
to Sarah. Turkey, welcome to Horovax.
A pleasure to be back in Turkey.
Yeah, it's also a big pleasure for us to continue the physical interviews. It's been a long time, huh?
One of my very first one, I have to
yeah,
say.
Yeah, yeah, thank
not
you.
Not by Zoom.
We are lucky, we are lucky. So anyway, before going on to the question, so how were the last 2 years? It was a very different and complicated period.
Last 2 years, I think we had to reinvent ourselves, you know. The good thing is that you have to reinvent yourself in 24 hours.
Absolutely.
Change everything, protect your customers, your staff, do Zoom meetings. But it was also an exciting time, I think.
Yeah.
Something crazy, but something where you could really change and change the whole thing, you know, the whole company. And I feel like we are going out of this time in a great shape.
It was a new world. Eh?
Lots of energy.
Yeah. Okay, for the luxury, the novelties are very important thing, very exciting thing for all of us. So what is your personal opinion about the novelties of the last year, let's say 2021?
I think we had an amazing time. Yeah. Amazing time, it watches a lot. Rethinking the whole approach, working on some very, very important launches. And this year, we had a lot of innovation, a lot of new stuff coming from Minerva to the more regular pieces. But mostly this year was also a very important year to start building what's going to happen. Yeah. That will not reveal, of course, today.
Yeah, of course. So anyway, I think in end of March, we will have again a physical exhibition and some surprises are waiting for us, I believe.
Definitely. First of all, I do hope we're going to have a physical exhibition, I think.
Yeah, we hope so.
This interaction, this moment, you know, that people know something's happening, that's the week, you have to focus, you have to really discover everything. And we're going to have a lot of surprises, but I think two very important messages. One on Minerva, and one on the more core collections. But that's going to change completely, I think, how people perceive the Montblanc and Minerva together.
We are very, very, very excited. Okay, you say Minerva. What makes the Minerva watches so special? So whenever we say Montblanc, of course, we recall also Minerva. So tell us something about the Minerva watches.
You know what? Minerva, for me, it's a little bit of this little jewel. If you go to Villeray in Switzerland and you enter that manufacturer and you see how it is like 200 years ago when people were producing watches without thinking profitability, without thinking I need to do a lot, but more thinking I want to enjoy watchmaking. And when I do something, I have to do everything. And that's a little bit the story of, you know, that we just had a big collaboration with Ferrari.
Yes, of course.
And I visited Ferrari, and for me, Minerva is the V12 of Ferrari. One watchmaker is following your watch from A to Z. And no one does that anymore in the watch industry. So if you ask me what is special, that is this particular part of, you know, that your watch, the one that has done the watch, can recognize his savoir-faire, his hands, and how he has done it, and he will tell you, oh, this is this watchmaker.
Good. Also, I consider this words as an invitation to Villeray factory, and soon we will be there, I hope. Eh?
As you say, physical is what makes the world.
Yeah.
And if you come, it's not a question of a marketing tool, it's a question of a real manufacturer. You can experience, and you can discover, and you feel it, you know. You feel like you're back to this old watchmaking world,
very important.
But with a lot of innovation.
Very important. Okay, in-house and manufacture, so recently they are the words very overused. So as Montblanc, which parts of your watches producing by yourself? So,
you know, I think it's very clear. There's no secret about that. If you see how all the collections of Montblanc are structured, they are all the same.
Mm-hmm.
You have always the high end, the top is the whole Minerva movements. And when you say Minerva, it means fully developed in-house, produced in-house. And the components, even the central organ, you know, this mainspring, and that we are even doing ourselves in Minerva. So, and then afterwards, you have a lot of pieces. For example, the one that I have, the Geosphere, which is becoming one of the iconic pieces at Montblanc, I have to say. And this whole module of the Geosphere was completely developed at Minerva. And then we have industry standards that we are using in our movements, like many other watch brands, and that are a different price positioning, but that are beautiful and very solid movements. So,
it's a real manufacturer movement.
Very open about it, and, from done in house to the best industry standards.
Very good, very good. Okay, if we look into luxury watchmaking, the themes like mountaineering, exploring, maybe perhaps the Montblanc is the only brand using this kind of themes. So what is the motivation behind?
And that's what I like, I think, is the combination of Minerva on the one hand, because Minerva, again, if you see the beautiful story of Minerva, starting in 1858, and in the 1920s and 30s, you had a lot of these what so-called military watches. Very open, you know, watches, resistant, they had to be very legible as well. And that's the whole inspiration of this ancient time, you know, where watches were meant for a purpose. And we thought that that was a very important era at Minerva that we wanted to celebrate. But on the other hand, if you think Montblanc, you think Montblanc, mountain, outside, exploration. And I think this story of exploration and innovation, which is so much what is Montblanc about, fits so well that we saw the Minerva and Montblanc again, the two together, and let's use the both energy and really the both themes to create this exploration scene. And because Montblanc, we are not a marketing maison, as you know, and we like genuine authenticity. That's why we wanted to associate with very cool persons. And that's what we did again with Reinhold Messner, for example, this year, telling different stories from climbing to crossing the desert. And I believe that fits really well with the Montblanc philosophy.
Yeah, definitely. Anyway, so by the way, taking this occasion, so you are here with us in Turkey, it's a big pleasure. And I also would like to announce from here, our fourth limited edition watch will be a collaboration with Montblanc. Thanks to Mr. Nicola Bareschi, so he helped us a lot, and we are almost ready, so we both saw the watch. So first of all, also thank you very much for this pleasure occasion for us, because it's really important to make a kind of collaboration with Montblanc. We will give the details later, but what do you think about this limited edition, special edition? So what is your personal opinion about it?
You know, when it comes to limited edition, I think there are different reasons for it. One of the first reasons for doing something with you, Sada, I think it's we didn't do it with anyone.
Yes, thank you.
The famous. Yeah, yeah. And why? First of all, I think it's a way to show the interest, the motivation, and the commitment of Montblanc here in Turkey.
In Turkey, yeah.
Doing a limited edition, I won't say too much, don't worry about it, but dedicated to a Turkish scene as well. I think is a way to show that we care and we want to give something special to our Turkish clients.
We are really very happy. Thank you very much again. And so, do you have any message to Turkish watch enthusiasts from here?
Well, I have a few messages. Number one, and I want to apologize to all of you, because this limited edition is rather limited, and I expect, like we've had recently with another limited edition in writing instrument, I expect some of you that might be a little bit upset for not getting it.
But, next one.
But that's the fun of collecting, you know? Sometimes you need to feel like it's difficult, and I can come back and the next one will be fun. So, and secondly, as I said, I think people, the more they discover about Montblanc watchmaking, and the more they see what is behind the watchmaking, will realize how in-depth of a watchmaker Montblanc is.
Yeah.
But with the beauty of having a global maison, and therefore being able to explore and with the maison a lot of things, and I have to say the years in front of us are pretty exciting.
Yeah. Anyway, I hope we will celebrate together. You will come to Turkey again, and we will have this joy all together when we release the watch. So for now, thank you very much, Nicola. It's really a big pleasure for us.
Thank you.
So let's do this, because I mean it's been a long time not doing this. So thank you very much, and hope to see you again soon.
Looking forward to celebrate the next collection.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.